Hello everyone, welcome to the Python tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to set up a list of students who can graduate. I would first have a list of students who cannot graduate, and then I will let the user enter some student names, and from those names entered, the computer would generate the student lists who are able to graduate. Okay, let us do the implementation. Suppose I have a blacklist of students who cannot graduate. Okay, these four students cannot graduate for some reasons. For example, they fail an examination. And then I will let the user input the names of other students. And I would like to check whether those students entered are able to graduate. So I would let the user input the number of students. So I set the number of students to be entered. Like this. In this case, the number of students are entered by the user, and then I would use numStudents to store the number of students that are going to be input to the system. Then I will create a list to store the student names that are going to be received. And I would set up a whitelist that stores the names that the students can graduate. So for the student list and the whitelist, they are now empty lists for the time being. And I will put the student names to the name to the student list, and I will put the names who are able to graduate to the whitelist. Since I already know the number of students to be received from the user input, I can use a for loop to allow the user input. Suppose the name is stored in the variable called prompt. If I want to check whether a user has really entered the student name, I can do something like this. If the user prompt is an empty string, that means if the user is not able to give a student name to the system, I will do something like this. I would urge the user to input a long empty name so that when the user wants to save the names of five students, I would really urge this user to give exactly five names. If the prompt is not an empty string, I would simply append the name received from user input to the student list. So at that time, the student list here will no longer be an empty list. After I have received and stored the student names from the user, I will do the checking. here. I will pick up a student name from the student list that I created previously. Here is the idea of the blacklist checking. If I have received the student names from the user input, I want to check each of the students in the student list, and I would like to see whether there is a student being in the blacklist already. If the student is actually not in the blacklist, I would append the student name to the whitelist. So the whitelist will store the student name who are able to graduate. After the completion of the for loop, I can simply print out the students in the whitelist, which means those who are able to graduate. Okay, first I would like to print out the number of students who are able to graduate. So I simply return the length of the whitelist. Since length of a whitelist is an integer, I would like to change it to a string before I can do the concatenation with other strings. Okay, and the last line of code here, I will sort the whitelist first in alphabetical order, and then I will print out every name stored in the whitelist by using a separator being the new line character. So I would print out the names one line by one line. So let us see the result of the code here. Suppose I have 5 students. The first name is, for example, Peter. The second name is an empty string. So you see, I have to enter a non-empty name. So I can input Carol. The third one is Susan. The fourth one is Robert, and the fifth one can be Ivy. And then from what I have input, I can return the 3 students who are able to graduate. It means that Carol, Ivy, and Peter are not in the blacklist. And for those who are in the blacklist, like Peter and Susan and Robert, they are not allowed to graduate, so I won't print out their names. My implementation is quite straightforward and intuitive, but it may not be the best version or the most efficient approach. If you can think about any improvement of my code, feel free to post your improvement on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel as well. Thank you for watching.